Good morning, good brothers and good sisters. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, good brothers, good sisters. I still see some people in bed. Well, rise and shine. Yes. Father's got the job for you.
Yeah. A little girl was always introducing herself as, "I am Mr. Grover's daughter."
Oh.
And one day mother heard her introducing herself like that with the people.
Right.
And the mother corrected her saying, "See, child, you should never introduce yourself as Mr. Grover's daughter, but you should introduce yourself as, I am Jane Grover."
Right.
Okay, well, one day the parish priest was visiting that village and he found this girl on the way playing with other kids.
Yeah.
And looking at the child, he said, "Oh, I think you are Grover's daughter." The little girl answered, "I thought I was, but mommy told me that I am not. I am Jane Grover."
The children are so innocent, you don't know what. One another innocent story for child. A child had this habit of sucking his thumb all the time.
Yeah.
So the mother had to get rid of the habit. She says, "Listen, son, if you keep sucking your thumb, your stomach will bloat and will burst one day." So immediately out of fear, he removed the thumb out. Went up. One day at the house, there was a big party, all friends and everybody had come. And among them was a pregnant lady. This fellow walked up to her and he says, "Auntie," and she says, "What?" He looks at the stomach and says, "I know what you have been doing." So that is the innocence of a child, okay? And auntie was like, "Oh my God, what is he talking about?"
You have to be very careful with the children when you say something.
Yes, yes, yes. Anyway, my dear brothers and sisters, favorite topic of the billions and billions, I think 99% must be so fond of this person, this character in the Bible, is our very own dear Mother Mary. Father, enlighten us on Mother Mary.
Yes.
I mean, it's so much there, but whatever
you
can tell.
Every time we speak about her.
Yes.
Okay. Mother Mary, if you have to say, one of the most controversial women in the history of religion.
Amen. Yes.
Because people speak so many things about her. There are people who make too much of her.
Yeah.
There are those people who belittle her. She is a woman of controversy, we can say.
Yes.
But she is the chosen one of God.
Amen.
And it is always the chosen ones of God have the controversies to face.
Yes. Well, the targets usually. Yeah,
surely. Okay. So we know her parents are Joseph and Anne, of the humble origin, and Mary was born in a very pious family tradition, and she was brought up in that way.
Yes.
And it seems she was rendering her services always at the synagogues or the temple where she was.
Yes.
And from being in a humble family, she had a great devotion to God.
Right.
In prayer.
Right.
It seems that in the temple, no women were allowed, but Mary was allowed to be
there. Yes.
So that was the...
Father, you Google this out.
Yeah, yeah.
She was the only one who could go into the Holy of Holies.
Oh, yes, yes. That is what this is. I heard about.
Yes.
Okay, I thought
just Google it out.
Yes.
And I was actually trying to prepare something, and I put this out. I said, "Wow, man, look at, I mean, from that time, Okay, then.
So, about being mother and being virgin, these are all the controversial topics. Even just a few days back, I heard one of the persons, of course in India, he wants to divert the attention of the present situation in India also.
Yes.
And he wants to bring hatred between the Christians and the other religions.
Yeah.
So, he spoke a lot of evils about Mother Mary. Okay. Also, that pained me very much to listen to that person. Of course, he's a paid servant of the
political party.
Because what he says today, tomorrow he says something else, and this is created there.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, he's not a person of faith, so I don't blame him. Ignorant person, so we pray like Jesus, Father, forgive him, for he knows not what
he's
doing, so that God may enlighten him. Maybe when I listened to him when he said like that, I thought that one day he'll become a preacher about Mother Mary.
Yes.
Why not? Possible. Let's pray for him.
Amen. Okay? Amen. Amen.
Yeah. So what do we know about Mary? In the scriptures, very little is mentioned. Little more than Joseph, we can say. So only in the early stages.
Yes.
that about her pregnancy, her going to visit Elizabeth and the birth of Jesus, going to Egypt. Yes. After that, what we know is Jesus when he's lost in the temple.
Yes.
Then in the during the ministry, once or twice, the wedding at Cana and all these things are there. But very few things are there. Mary has spoken little. But Mary is known to be a courageous person. That is one of the qualities that we need to imitate of Mary. The angel Gabriel, the angel of God coming and telling her, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." Okay? And announcing that you will conceive and bear a son, will be his name will be Emmanuel, his name is Son of God, and all that. And this lady is so courageous, challenging. How can that be possible? I'm still a virgin. She does not take easily anything, even the message from God, but she did not take it, you know, for granted. She questioned because she wanted understanding, enlightenment.
Correct.
For example, the same question was asked by Zechariah,
right,
the uncle of Mary, cousin's husband, cousin's husband,
Elizabeth's husband.
When he asked, he was punished. He became dumb.
Yeah.
Mary asks, she is not dumb, because she did not doubt. The difference between Zechariah, he doubted.
Yes.
Here Mary did not doubt. She knew for God everything is possible. So did not doubt. Therefore, she is not punished.
Yes.
She asked for clarification here. Yes. So that is why she questioned.
Exactly.
How can this be possible? Amazing. So we see the courage of Mary here.
Yeah.
And then when she went to Bethlehem to register the name. You see her courage. She's fully pregnant. Now time for delivery is almost close.
Right.
She's not reluctant. She's ready to follow the norms of the society also.
Amen.
She's not giving up.
Yes. Yes.
So she follows the norms and goes to with courage and strength, because God was with her. That was the strength of God was her strength.
Correct.
And from there, for the delivery, there's nobody. There is no maid to assist her. And yet she is courageous to give birth. She is not worried, not disturbed. Give birth to Jesus. And from there again, when Jesus was born, her courage to take the plight into Egypt.
Yeah.
And to take care of Jesus, to come back. And then when he was 12 years of old, when she went to the temple, when Jesus was there, she was courageous. The people were sitting there. But she knows, though he is Son of God, she knows that he is the Son of God, and she knows that he is her son.
Yes.
So she has the courage. "Son, why did you do this to us?
Yes.
Your father and I were looking for you, worried, we are disturbed. Why did you do this?"
Correct.
And when Jesus answered her, she does not go to question second time. She is not a nagging woman.
Yes. Yes.
And she had what she has to say. She is very clear about it. Said it. Yes. She brought him and came home.
Right.
And she taught him to be obedient. Exactly. So that's what the Bible says. He was obedient to the parents. Then when he began his public ministry, she had the courage. She knew that Jesus is the Son of God. And she introduces him to the public ministry through the miracle at Cana.
Exactly.
So first she says, "Son, there is no wine in the inn." Jesus says, "Woman, this is not my concern." But she's not worried about his answer. She knows it's her son. Therefore, she tells the disciples, "Go and do what he tells you to do."
Amen.
That is her courage. She said, "Go and do what he tells you to do." And that is the strength Mother Mary has, and that she tells not only to the apostles, she's telling you and me, do what her son is telling you to do.
Amen.
Then only we can be the true disciples of Jesus Christ. Otherwise, we cannot be the disciples of Jesus Christ.
Beautiful.
So that is the message we can take from Mother Mary, to do what Jesus tells us to do. Then only we can be true disciples of Jesus Christ. Then only we can be the true children of Mother Mary.
Amen.
Okay? There is a lot of devotions to Mother Mary.
Yes.
They are growing up. Okay. Now, still continuing with the courage of Mother Mary, again, when Jesus was dying, all had left.
She was there.
But she was there, fearless woman.
She was
courageously standing at the foot of the cross.
Yes.
Not disturbed, and looking at the Son straight into his eyes and telling, "Son, don't worry. This is the plan of God."
Amen.
She did not cry, did not get disturbed. So she was remaining as a strength. So Mother Mary is our strength too. When we are in trials, difficulties, that does not mean that Mother Mary will bring us down from the cross suffering.
Correct.
Praying to Mother Mary is a strength for us to bear the pain.
Amen.
So we have to learn that also from Mother Mary.
Amen.
Okay. Again, there is, I said, she's a controversial woman when he started. Also, there is the question about her virginity.
Yes.
Because in the scripture it is mentioned, her brother, Jesus' your mother, your brother, your sisters have come to see you.
Yeah. Correct.
So again, they say that how come with the brother and sister of is there?
Yeah.
So they are cousins, because in each culture, the different way of addressing the relatives are is there.
Yeah.
For example, in certain countries, when even the uncle is known as father.
Oh.
That does not mean that your physical father.
Uncle,
father's brother is father. Mother's sister is known as mother.
Only.
They don't. So in their culture, the cousins known as brothers and sisters. They don't say your cousin brother. It's an English way.
Yeah.
So that is the language they use. Therefore, Mary was pure, virgin. Her purity was there even at the time of when Mary's mother conceived her. That time onwards, till that time of her death, she was pure and holy. There is no doubt about it.
That is why she has taken body and soul.
Body and soul into heaven.
Amen. You know, Father, two things that really strike me. One is when she accepted what Gabriel said. She must be knowing that she can be stoned to death.
Surely.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
But yet she was brave enough. Like what you said, brave, yeah? Another thing, always it was a revelation when she asked Jesus, turn the water. Wine is over. Woman, my time is not yet up, right?
Yes.
But did she plead? Did she beg? It was a direct command.
She
didn't beg, son, please do this, how they. She just, it's a direct command. So that is the power she holds even today with her son.
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
We should understand that. And those fools who, you know, are belittling Mother Mary, bringing her down, they are blind, absolutely blind. They don't realize.
But one day they will change.
One day they will change. We shall. Let us pray for those.
God, our loving Father, we thank and praise you for the gift of Mother Mary as our mother. Through your Son Jesus Christ on the cross, you made her our mother and our intercessor. May we always come to her as a loving mother in every need of ours, to pray to her and also listen to her when she tells us, do what my son tells you to do. And may she teach us to do everything that has been taught to us by your Son Jesus Christ, to love you and love our neighbors. We ask in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus loves you. A wonderful day.
My dear brothers and sisters, before we end,
Those
of you who have not said a rosary, try saying a rosary.
Yes.
As the Padre Pio used to say, get me my weapon.
Yes.
And his weapon was the rosary.
Yes.
Try it out and you'll see beautiful things happen.
Yes.